Do you want to know more about cryptocurrency but aren't sure where to start? Welcome to Empower and Thrive. I'm Christina, a corporate VP in the finance industry with over 20 years experience. In today's video, we're venturing into a topic that's capturing headlines everywhere: cryptocurrency. You've probably heard about Bitcoin, Ethereum, or maybe even Dogecoin. But what is crypto exactly? How does it work? And should you even consider it? If you've been wondering about any of this, you're in the right place because we're going to break down the basics of cryptocurrency in a way that's easy to understand. First, let's start with some basic terms often used in the crypto space. In cryptocurrency, there are a few important terms to know. The blockchain is like a public digital notebook where every transaction is recorded, but instead of one person controlling it, many people have copies, making it very secure. A liquidity pool is like a big pot of money made up of different people's contributions. This pot helps people trade their cryptocurrency easily without waiting for a buyer or seller. Mining is when people use special software to solve complex puzzles, which is how new transactions are added to the blockchain. The miners earn cryptocurrency for doing it. Smart contracts are like digital agreements that automatically complete transactions once certain conditions are met, without needing a middleman. A wallet is a tool, like a digital bank account, that you use to store, send, or receive your cryptocurrencies. Cryptocurrency has experienced explosive growth since it started. What started as a niche digital experiment has now grown into a market with a total value of over $1 trillion. In just over a decade, Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies have captured the attention of investors, financial institutions, and even governments worldwide. Cryptocurrency is essentially digital money. Unlike the cash in your wallet or the balance in your bank account, cryptocurrency doesn't exist in physical form. It's entirely digital. But what makes crypto different from other forms of digital money, like the funds in your PayPal account, is how it's managed. Traditional money is controlled by banks and governments, but cryptocurrency operates on a technology called blockchain, which is decentralized, meaning no single entity, like a bank, controls it. So, how does this blockchain technology actually work? Imagine a blockchain as a huge, transparent ledger, a record book that everyone in the network has a copy of. Every time a cryptocurrency transaction is made, it's recorded on this ledger. Now, here's where it gets interesting. Instead of one central authority, like a bank, being responsible for updating the ledger, every computer in the network, called nodes, has to verify and agree on the transaction before it gets added to the blockchain. This verification process involves solving complex mathematical problems in a process called mining. To make it even simpler, think of the blockchain as a long chain of blocks, with each block containing a list of recent transactions. When a block is filled up, it's added to the chain, and a new block begins. The magic of the blockchain is that once a block is added, it's nearly impossible to change. This makes blockchain technology highly secure and transparent because every transaction is out in the open for the network to see, and tampering with it would require altering every block that came before it, which is practically impossible. Now, you might be asking, why would people choose to use cryptocurrency instead of regular money? For starters, cryptocurrency transactions can be faster and cheaper, especially for international transfers. Because crypto doesn't rely on banks as intermediaries, you can send money directly to someone else anywhere in the world, often with lower fees and quicker processing times than traditional banks offer. Plus, because of the way blockchain works, these transactions are secure and verifiable by the entire network. Another reason people are drawn to cryptocurrency is the idea of decentralization. With traditional money, central banks control the supply, printing more money when they see fit, which can lead to inflation. Cryptocurrency, on the other hand, is often designed with a fixed supply. For example, there will only ever be 21 million bitcoins. This limited supply is one reason people see Bitcoin as digital gold, a store of value that isn't subject to inflation like traditional currencies. But while all of this might sound exciting, it's crucial to understand that cryptocurrency is still a very young and rapidly changing space. And with that comes risk, serious risk. This brings us to an important topic, fraud. The decentralized nature of cryptocurrency, which is one of its biggest selling points, also makes it a breeding ground for scams. There's been a lot of fraudulent activity in the crypto world, from fake investment schemes to hacking attacks that drain people's wallets. It's not uncommon to hear stories of people who thought they were investing in the next big cryptocurrency, only to lose everything when the project turned out to be a scam, or someone stole the funds out of the liquidity pool, making trades or selling nearly impossible. Because the crypto market is still largely unregulated, it's much easier for scammers to prey on unsuspecting investors. That's why it's so important to do thorough research before investing in any cryptocurrency. You need to be aware of the risks and only put in money that you're willing to lose. Never invest more than you can afford to lose. This is one of the most important rules when it comes to cryptocurrency because the market is incredibly volatile. Understanding market volatility is crucial in cryptocurrency, as prices can soar one day and crash the next. This unpredictability also gives rise to a variety of different scams, a couple of which are pump and dump schemes and rug pulls. In a pump and dump scheme, scammers artificially inflate the price of a low volume cryptocurrency through misleading hype, often through social media hype and influencers. Then insiders sell off their holdings at the peak, leaving other investors with heavy losses. In a rug pull scam, developers create a cryptocurrency, attract investors, and suddenly abandon the project, taking all the assets with them or draining the entire liquidity pool, leaving investors with worthless assets. Staying informed about these tactics is essential to protecting your investments. Aside from scams, another risk is security. While blockchain technology is secure, individual crypto wallets can be vulnerable if they're not properly protected. There's no customer service to help you recover your funds if you lose access to your wallet or if it gets hacked. So securing your crypto is critical. This often means using strong passwords, two-factor authentication, and even hardware wallets, which store your crypto offline and are less vulnerable to cyberattacks. Now, let's quickly talk about the different types of cryptocurrencies. Bitcoin, as the first cryptocurrency, often gets the most attention, but there are thousands of other cryptocurrencies, each with its own unique features. Ethereum, for example, isn't just a currency. It's also a platform for building decentralized applications, or dApps, which are apps that run on the blockchain. Then, there are stablecoins, which are designed to maintain a stable value by being pegged to a reserve asset, like the US dollar. These coins aim to offer the benefits of cryptocurrency without the extreme volatility. But remember, not all cryptocurrencies are created equal, and not all of them will succeed in the long run. The market is still evolving, and while some cryptos might become widely adopted, others could fade into obscurity. That's why it's important to focus on understanding the fundamentals before jumping in. Educate yourself about how blockchain works, how different cryptocurrencies function, and what you're actually investing in. At the end of the day, cryptocurrency is still in its early stages, and while it holds promise, it's essential to approach it with caution. For beginners, I recommend starting small, learning as much as you can, and staying informed about the latest developments in the crypto world. And as I mentioned earlier, always remember the golden rule: never invest more than you can afford to lose. Cryptocurrency can be part of a balanced financial portfolio, but it shouldn't be your only strategy. So, if you're excited about the potential of cryptocurrency, great. But be smart, be cautious, and make sure you understand the risks involved. If you want to know more about stock market basics, I put the link to that video here. I'll see you in the next video. And as always, keep thriving.